I'm talking about.
Ooh, I need that.
What?
Oh, I need that. Oh, I need that. What?
That shit look like it feel good.
Oh, yeah, come here. Let me show you this shit real fast. Hey,
y'all alone. Man, sit your ass down,
oh, man.
I
was finna show you that shit, dog.
What is it though, man? What you trying to show me?
It's some good shit. I was gonna show you in there so I could show
you. It's a real workout?
It's some good shit.
Why you say it's some good shit? It's a workout though.
Come on, let me show you. Show you too.
Bro, we
y'all gonna really appreciate it.
Bro, we filming. I know you. You know what I'm saying? Being in the gym and shit, bro. Like, we filming.
Nah, you better cut this shit off the motherfucking film, dude.
No. No.
You better cut this shit off the motherfucking film. Shit. Man. I edit this out. I got it.
what you did this week? Or last week? Because it's Monday.
Man, I got to look at my calendar, dog.
Now, off the top of your head, you can't remember?
I just done so much, man.
Yeah.
Let's see, since I last seen you, I did them two listening parties back to back.
Yeah. Hey, you, I know you a, fuck it, man, I don't give a fuck. You a single man, right?
Yeah.
Is there anything that you miss having, you know what I'm saying? And is it anything where you be like, nah, real talk, bro, because that relationship should be a motherfucker sometime. Because I say that shit because you talking about, I asked you what you did this week, and then I'm thinking about what I did this week. I was kind of in turmoil. I was fucking
about
weak.
About what? What happened?
Just, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to go down into everything, you know what I'm saying?
Me,
but
give me a synopsis.
Frustrations. How about that? You know what I'm saying? Frustrations and shit. But, so, really, the catalyst of one of our biggest issues in our relationship is my activity on social media.
Hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, motherfuckers that I
follow.
I've had a bad history.
Multiple accounts, bro.
I understand that, bro. But it don't have the same effect if it ain't coming directly from me. But then I had a bad situation with comments in the past, you know what I'm saying? Making comments and shit.
I'm not motherfucking Derrick Jackson, nigga. I'm not the motherfucking Kevin, what's his name, nigga?
Yeah.
Don't make me the relationship guy, man.
Now I want to know. So if you got into a relationship,
I can't give you no advice on your relationship.
No, I don't want no fucking, especially not from you.
Yeah, I can only point out where the issue coming from. I'm not the relationship advice ass nigga.
Hey, so if you got into a relationship and a woman was like kind of monitoring your social media to a certain degree, if that's the right, because I made a post on Facebook, bro, and I had somebody respond in the inbox, and they was like, man, all women do that shit.
So,
you know what I'm saying? They be kind of on that shit.
On a couple social media platforms, I'm strictly business. I'm all professional, you know.
Yeah.
I live a public life, but my private life is private on those platforms. On another platform, it's a little bit less professional and more free with my words. I'm really not friends with my significant others on those platforms. I never have been. I never just say, it's just better if you do your thing. I like you like this. I ain't got to know what's going on over there.
Right, right.
Good.
But I'm saying, if in the scenario, I don't think you hear me. In the scenario, because I kind of want to know like what people think too, bro. You know what I'm saying? In the scenario that you in a relationship. Do y'all women go through y'all shit? Do y'all women look and see who y'all following on Instagram? Who y'all liking? You know what I'm saying? Like keeping. I had to ask this motherfucker one time. I say, man, and that's my baby. I love her. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I never, you know. I had to ask this motherfucker. I said, man, you got some type of app that keep track of what the fuck I'm liking or what the fuck I'm coming and when I get motherfucking follower changes and shit like
probably,
that.
She probably put you on her RSS
It's
feed.
Not about her. You're not finna sit here and talk about her.
You saying, know what I'm saying? You on her RSS, you to her.
What the fuck that is.
That's that algorithm talk, man. That's that.
But would you be okay with a, you know what I'm saying? You in a committed relationship, engaged. Would you be okay with that?
Which version of this are you asking? Are you asking the younger me or the me
I'm
today?
I'm asking you today.
The me today, I wouldn't have no problem with it because I ain't really fucking with no cheating shit. I'm good being single, so if I'm gonna fuck with you, I'm stuck with you.
So you wouldn't even like people pictures no more? You wouldn't?
Yeah, I'm still gonna like pictures and shit.
You might still put the fire emoji up under the in Absolutely. The comment.
Absolutely.
You still might follow beautiful women fucking that may right. have nothing to do with fucking what you right. do.
I'm yeah. where I want to be. I'm still going to do what I...
And if
this,
somebody
This ain't got shit to do with nothing but either business or simple male shit. Let me be a nigga.
Oh, man. That's the part I don't think females really understand.
Let me be a nigga.
Because especially if you're not going to... If you're not doing nothing.
Especially if I'm a faithful nigga.
Just let me be... Check let the, me have my little nigga moments.
Check the DMs and shit.
You know what I'm saying?
Ain't nothing going on.
As I ain't fucking
you,
nothing.
Yeah, as long as you keeping it a buck, do your thing, man.
God damn That's, it. I am Hypes Out.
I am DJ Nightcap.
And this is
Throwed in the Game.
I'm so cold in the game. But artists of the decade, dude, you know what I'm saying? Drake got artists of the decade. They listed out all the different.
Who else was nominated?
I don't think it was no nomination. I think that was kind of like some... I could be wrong, you know what I'm saying? But I'm thinking it's on some lifetime achievement type of shit where they just come in and they, all right, this year.
See, we need a screen.
It's time
man.
To give a artist of the decade shit and Drake artist of the decade.
How you feel about that?
Shit. I don't know. He definitely, the numbers don't lie. But I guess I just on some dry hating ass shit, I just wish it could have went to somebody else.
He's the best doing it right now, right?
I think Lil Baby the best doing it right now. But
I think J. Cole it is.
How? That nigga not even on the radio like that. He not even.
That's the marker for you?
I mean, okay, I look at it like, you know what I'm saying, who they pushing the hardest, who they driving down your throat, you know what I'm saying, pause, you know what I'm saying, who they driving down your, through your ears, you know what I'm saying?
Like, Baby is the future.
The Baby is now Drake, and the future.
Drake is still right now. This is still Drake's. This, we are at the tail end of Drake's era, but you still gonna respect Drake, bro. At this... Baby ain't doing the numbers that Drake is doing.
I think that nigga got more positions on the chart right now than Drake.
No, Baby got more position in the streets
On the chart. I think he got more positions on the chart right now than Drake.
Bro, more slaps than the Beatles.
That's cool. But you know, he's not gonna have the next artist of the decade next.
So you talking about Lil Baby is LeBron when he first came into the league. And everybody, LeBron, LeBron, LeBron. Then Kobe said, let me go and win two back-to-back to show y'all it's still my league. This is still Drake's league. Until he decided to say, you know what? Here you go, dog. But then after that, it is Lil Baby.
What more can Drake do, though, right now? What more could Drake possibly do? As a fan of music, what more could Drake possibly do to not even impress you, but just be like, you not tired of him yet?
I know what I like certain Drake, not all Drake. I'm not no big Drake fanatic.
But are you tired of the nigga yet? He kind of like he cheating.
Why?
Like he got a cheat code.
Yeah, it's called the power of the internet, social media, rapid news. You know.
What more could he do right now to
nothing? This the game is, bro. If Drake stopped making music, the hip hop business would be bankrupt. Drake is supporting the entire hip hop business. Everybody who listens to any streaming service has more than one Drake song in more than one playlist. You probably do too. because he got a few you like. The nigga could do a show of number one hits for 3.5 hours. Baby on his way, though. I don't see how you could argue me down about Meg Thee Stallion being a superstar, but can't see how this is still Drake's arena.
Like, okay, I get it, right? I get it, right? That's kind of like how you brought in LeBron shit, right? How LeBron really kind of supporting the NBA until they get another superstar. You know what I'm saying? They really right now, holding on to
it's
LeBron.
LeBron's league.
It's LeBron's league. And they looking for whoever going to come up and take the throne and
just
be the
like
next
LeBron
superstar.
Was when he came.
Right.
And it was and still Kobe, Kobe's league.
Yeah. And from Jordan to Kobe.
Kobe
then,
to
you know
LeBron.
What I'm saying? Magic to Jordan.
Now you wrapping your head around some shit.
I get it. But damn, hurry the fuck up.
Hey, you sound like the mo get off my lawn ass nigga.
Like you on a what a Drake rank in your all time?
Five. He's in the top five.
Like all time.
Not, I ain't saying
what's
my
the standard
favorite,
though.
My favorite top five, but my objective top five.
What is the standard for?
Skill. Influence, numbers, longevity. There you go.
Then damn. If that's the case, he may be five. If not, maybe six.
The top five is arguable who you want to put where.
With that, but with that shit right there that you said, you got to put Snoop in there, right? Influence, skill. Snoop was a bad motherfucker back in the gap.
Yeah,
he was a bad motherfucker.
He was. He's,
you talking about longevity? Here's niggas.
Here's the thing about
30 years.
So when you start
Ice Cube.
But look, listen, man. When you get to the top, you got to start picking halves. You know what I'm saying? Splitting halves. So the thing about Snoop is, Jay-Z continued to put out albums that were influential every time he dropped and went multiple platinum. Eventually, Snoop started putting out singles that were influential and that will go multiple platinum. And his albums would do pretty good.
But Snoop has always remained influential on the culture.
Yeah, but his...
To this day.
But people like Drake and Jay-Z and Tupac, they put out album after album after album, and every album influenced the entire landscape of our culture.
But outside of music, Drake dropping a dope album, you know what I'm saying, dominating the charts. This long one is 400 something weeks consecutive being on the chart. All that shit, that's cool, and that's cute. Most laughs in the beat, all that shit, that's cool. But outside of that, where's this, like Jay-Z, when you talk about Jay-Z influence, that shit reach outside
Lil
of
Wayne,
just dropping an album.
Lil Wayne dropped album after album.
He dropped album after album. That nigga changed the culture. That nigga had niggas skateboarding. He had niggas wearing Vans. Had people, niggas, tats all in their face. That's influence. Drake, I don't know if Drake fall in that category of that type of influence. I'm sorry. Snoop, Lil Wayne, Jay-Z, Tupac.
Snoop. I can't go down with Snoop in my five. My five is Jay-Z, Lil Wayne.
Cube definitely too, dog. Like, Cube is a fucking factor. Cube is a fucking factor. I don't know if Drake has the type of influence like fucking those five people.
What?
You talking about just rapping?
No matter what.
Even in rapping, if
no
you talking about
what,
rapping back in the gap, no nigga, them niggas
what,
wasn't fucking
now
with.
Cube is a great pull. A great pull, and I can't even. Oh, I'm kind of mad at myself.
Well, I say he might be six,
but no matter
might
what,
be seven,
Drake is in the
going.
Conversation. But it's Jay-Z, Pop, Wayne,
Snoop,
Drake.
Come on, dude. Come on, dude. This nigga's ridiculous. Come on, don't name. Just name them fuckers.
And
like,
DMX.
Ooh, it's getting rough in this motherfucker. How? I'll put DMX six. I'll put DMX in that bitch before I put Drake. I won't put him in the top five. Long live DMX. Much respect to him, much love to him. But me personally, I'm not finna put him, you know what I'm saying, as much influence as fucking Snoop. He had more influence than Snoop? Come on, bro. Snoop, you know how many commercials Snoop done been in? How many people that he done helped sell products? Snoop, that's influence.
Hey, that's because Snoop 50 and Drake is where he at 35, my nigga.
We talking about DMX now. You going to put DMX above Snoop?
God rest his soul was 50 and Drake 35 and in the conversation.
You know who I put above Drake to? 50 Cent.
Oh, hell no, man.
Hello.
But not more than Drake. 50 Cent
know,
is a top tenner.
I don't know.
He's a top tenner.
You done drunk vitamin water? Have you ever drank it?
I have, dude.
I got one in my ice box right now.
I'm drinking.
You know what I'm saying?
I can't tell y'all.
I got one in the icebox right now. You ever watch Power?
It is purple, though.
You ever watch Power? You bumping that motherfucker. It got to be something in that motherfucker. Have you ever watched Power?
Yeah, I've watched Power.
You watched Power
50 Cent is a great television producer, dog.
You ever listen to Get Rich or Die? I'm talking about in different sectors of life. Have you ever listened to Get Rich or Die Try?
Yeah, dog.
You did?
Yeah, dog.
By any chance. By any fucking chance. Would you understand... Those are three different sectors of life. Food and beverage.
50 Cent will be in the top 10, but he's not above Drake. You talking about success.
No, I'm talking about influence. Influence, my brother.
Drake is up there, dog. And I ain't even no Drake fan like that.
Is he a great musician? Yes. Great musician. He make great music. Fuck all that shit out talking about everybody to dry hate.
Hey, he's in the hall. With the elite of the elite of the elite of the elite.
But he not above. I'm not, you talking about longevity. You can't say
bro,
the shit you were saying.
This nigga got like 10 albums, 8, 9 number ones or something, whatever the numbers.
That's cute.
Millions of trillions of billions of sales.
And then what, has he ever come out with a chip or anything? Master P.
Has he ever,
influence. I'm saying just
said,
anything. I'm saying anything outside
said,
of music.
Has he ever come
has he
out
influenced
with
culture
chip?
Outside of music? Has he influenced with even with style, like Lil Wayne did. He influenced with style.
Master P didn't have the musician level respect to be in this conversation. He had the business acumen, but we all know P wasn't making music. He was making chants that the hood could ride with.
Influence is just a big influence, a big thing.
He wasn't in there spitting bars, like all these other rappers we talking about that's really spitting bars. He was spitting music we could relate to. And we appreciate he was from where we from.
So if we just said, okay, fuck top five, because I think the question was like top five, you know what I'm saying, rappers or something, you know. So if we just influence, top five influence, you still got Drake.
But I'm not taking out my other factors.
No, I'm saying brand new fucking list. It's a fucking new list, a different fucking list. Top five influences.
It's a different list, dog.
Different fucking list at this point. Does he still? Because I want to make sure that I ain't mixing nothing up. And you know what I'm saying? We were talking about that, but top five influences. Drake's still a top five influencer to you.
Yeah.
Fuck no.
Yeah.
That's bananas.
You know how many?
That's bananas.
Hey, when y'all leave y'all
that's
comments,
bananas.
Before you even leave the comments, because I kind of know what most of y'all going to say, appreciate you.
Man, you be talking to them people like them people fuck with you, man. Them people fuck with me, man. Them people fuck with me, man.
See, that's that dry hate, boy. That's that dry hate.
Nigga, but cause you know why they don't fuck with you? You want to know why?
Go ahead and tell me why.
Because you be saying some wild-ass shit. He be saying some wild ass shit, dog.
You mean like Drake ain't one of the top five greatest rappers of
influencers.
All time?
Influencers. We all for that. He's still
great. Great. Drake ain't one of the top five goats of the music of rap. The top five best rappers to ever do this rap shit. Drake is in the top five, dog.
I don't know.
Even
Daddy
if you put him at number five, Drake is in the top. One of the best do it.
I didn't. If it's strictly music and numbers and all that shit there.
Everything
okay.
matter, dog.
But when you start factoring in other things.
Everything matter.
The fucking scale kind of tips
everything,
out of his favor.
Everything. Okay.
It tips out of his fucking favor.
Okay. I disagree, dog.
That's why they don't fuck with you, man.
That's why they don't fuck
with
you, dog.
That's why they don't fuck
with
you, man.
You closed minded, dog. You need to open your mind. You probably think.
That nigga said DMX over Snoop? Come on, bro. Like, that's crazy. That shit's fucking crazy.
Oh.
That shit's crazy.
Hey, it's so close, they had to do a versus battle for it. Oh, yeah. Go back and watch the versus battle.
Who won that versus, in your opinion? Yeah. Man, you going to say shit, DMX? That's
too much life ago, but I have to refresh myself.
Straight up. That shit crazy, man. You, man, I want you to do me a favor. You know what I'm saying?
See how you don't see that, dog.
If it's strictly music, my nigga, like, if it's strictly music.
Everything matters.
And if everything matter, then that nigga don't fit the bill.
Ooh.
He don't fit the description.
Ooh, I don't know, dog.
He don't fit the fucking description.
I don't know, dog. You know this nigga's like the king of Toronto, man.
He don't fit the description. I'm king of Toronto, my motherfucking ass. That don't make no difference to me.
I don't know, man.
That don't make no difference to me. I'm king of motherfucking, man, fuck all that king of Toronto shit. Toronto just now making their mark in the music industry.
With Drake.
Cool.
And he's number one in the States.
Cool, Cap. Drake has more influence. Has more influence than Ice Cube to you. Drake has more influence. And when I say influence, we talking about just influence, bro. You know what influence is. Music and which niggas charted and all. Man, this nigga start a basketball league, bro. Let's start a fucking basketball league, bro.
I'm saying everything matters.
You ever been to the Big Three?
Yeah, I've seen it.
You been?
No.
Bro, this nigga start a basketball league, bro.
I've seen it, huh?
Influence? Niggas that hang it up, you know what I'm saying? These are multi-million dollar niggas trusting him and his investment group and all that.
But you compare a rapper's career to guys in their 45s and 50s to a current rapper. What do you think Drake might be doing when he get to the age Ice Cube was when he made a basketball league?
When did Friday come out? In the midst of his fucking rap career.
So now you done open up a whole new conversation.
Influence.
You
wouldn't have Chris Tucker without Ice Cube. Wouldn't have Rush Hour series without fucking Ice Cube.
Who bought an Ice Cube album after he started making movies? Raise your hand.
What you talking about?
Nuff said.
Let's go look and see what motherfucking year he dropped Friday. And then go look at the day, the album and shit like that, man.
While he looking, man, in the meantime, man, let me let y'all know about GMT Video Vibes, dog. You really need to check it out. There's some dope stuff going on over there. You can even catch some of the replays of our best pods, man. You know what I'm saying? So go check that shit out, dog.
So Friday came out in 1993. I'm going to say 1995. I'm sorry. Friday came out in 1995.
You could do it. Put your back into it.
Friday came out in 1995. And...
that was some good music, though.
Okay, the album's kind of... Laugh Now, Cry Later was cool.
Cool. Everything, cool. Looking ass.
Did that take away from his influence?
What I'm saying is, you comparing what Michael Jordan is doing right now to what LeBron doing right now. LeBron is still playing. LeBron still get a chance to stop making music and go on and do some shit.
And that's a very, very valid point. That's a very
Drake is still
response.
Active right
it's
now.
It's not good enough, Cap.
Oh, man, get the fuck out of here, man.
It's a very educated response. I really like that response. It's just not fucking
top
good
five,
enough.
Dog. Niggas top five already at this age, dog. You tripping, man. The fact that he's in the conversation with Jay-Z,
you
Ice
forcing
Cube,
the nigga in there.
Because he
you
is.
You forcing the nigga, though.
I ain't have to force
you
nothing.
You forcing that nigga, though.
Nigga. I ain't have to.
You forcing that shit, bro. That nigga, that nigga. No, clearly don't have more influence than Tupac. Clearly don't have more influence than Jay-Z. Clearly don't have more influence than Lil Wayne. Come on, Cap, man. Don't make me walk out of here, bro. Don't make me walk out of here, bro. Like, you can't be. I said Tupac,
he's in the top five.
Jay-Z and Lil Wayne, you already.
He's in the top five with him.
Clearly, don't have more influence than those three. Without argument, without debate.
No, we can play then we go of deduction all day, but
50
he's,
Cent.
He's in the top five.
50 Cent. 50 Cent. More influence 50 Cent, right?
50 Cent, another retired rapper doing, having the freedom and the career and has built the cachet to go do other things. So what do you think Drake's cachet size that he's building right now is going to be?
I would hope.
All of the rappers you naming had to go do other shit just to be as big as Drake is right now.
Who?
If they had not did that other shit, they would not be as big as Drake is just on music. You tripping, dog. You need to, you know, wake up and smell the rest of the nation besides Houston, Texas, and Louisiana.
You can't use that forever, bro.
It sound like I need to do it now.
I ain't mentioned Houston, a Houston nigga one time today, but that's your scapegoat
to try to devalue
what I say.
You got Dougie D in your top five, don't you?
Listen to him, man. I can't even have a conversation with this nigga. That's why they don't. That's why y'all don't like him, huh?
Cause I'm right. They
that's why y'all don't like this.
Drake,
I get it.
Not top five, dog.
And get what? Y'all just gotta listen to it. Y'all just gotta watch it. I gotta sit there every day, every motherfucking week, talk to this nigga and hear this foolishness, bro. This nigga, man. This type of shit I gotta deal with. This shit's ridiculous, man. This shit's ridiculous, man.
Yeah, I don't understand.
I don't even know who I won Artist of the Decade before that. You know what I'm saying? But
we need a screen man.
But he definitely fit.
Boss, we need a screen man.
he definitely motherfucking Artist of the Decade. Cool, you know what I'm saying? Little dry hate, but top five influencer. It's just a little bit too much for me. It's a little too much for me. You know what I'm saying? For you, it may be that he fit the description.
Bro, I tell you one of
and them. That's okay. That's okay, Cap. That's okay, bro. Don't worry about it, bro.
I'm
going to
tell
it's
you
okay.
One of the biggest effects Drake has on the culture, bro.
Man, I don't even want to talk about it no more, Cap. It's okay.
Niggas is singing to strippers in the club while they throwing money at these bitches. And I just want to love you. They singing Drake songs.
That's the biggest influence you can come up with.
Outside of fucking.
You talking about a nigga that done got multi-million dollar deal with stars and got motherfucking.
Hey, if you don't understand that, come on, man. If you don't understand that, then I'm gonna find you a new supplier, dog.
Motherfucking G Unit, and all that shit. We wouldn't have Pop Smoke right now. Pump the Brakes. Nigga, executive produced Pop Smoke album and shit Ice Cube wouldn't have Are You There Yet? Wouldn't
all
have Motherfucking Friday.
Retired.
Wouldn't have All About the Benjamin. Wouldn't have Mike Epps.
Retired rappers doing, man. Nigga. This nigga active, on, dog. Man. Talk to me about.
You want
to
see. What if Drake becomes a great actor? If he becomes a great actor.
He was already a great actor before he was a rapper, dog.
I don't know if he was a great actor. I know he was an actor.
That show lasted a long time.
Shit. I don't know if it lasted because of him.
Go watch it then and find out.
Not interested.
You don't know. Nigga looked
weird back then.
Nigga was a kid. Shit.
Yeah, weird looking ass kid.
Nigga was a kid. You looked weird as a kid too, nigga.
Nah, I was a tough kid.
Still's a weird looking tough kid. God damn. Smell anything going on around that block, boy.
Nigga know the mama's cooking. Nah, man, fuck you, man.
You tripping, man.
Nah, man. I just can't get with that. And this ain't even dry hate. This is me being realistic.
You do sound like the old get off my lawn ass nigga.
No. That's not what that is. If he can, you've said some very bright things. I'm not gonna take that away from you, bro. Like the rappers, he an active rapper, and then that shit.
You know we got fans that'll reach out about this shit too.
I understand. That. And then when you said I forgot in my head, like he was a professional actor prior to him becoming a rap star, a rap phenomenon. I'm gonna get a nigga's flower.
Wait till the driver hear this.
When he stopped rapping, I'm an action type of guy, I'm a drama type of guy, suspense type of guy. If Drake can get into some shit like that, I don't want to see a nigga acting in a romance.
Dog.
I don't want to see the nigga act. I don't want to see him Dog. Action movie, but I want to see if Drake can really act. I never watched Degrassi.
Drake's active rap career is bigger than Snoop's. His active rap career, not the shit that he did after he really just kind of put the mic down and might drop a song here and there when niggas was still dropping an album every year, a year or two. Active rap career, going on tour, all that shit. His rap career is bigger than motherfucking 50 Cent's, Snoop's, Nelly's, some big dogs, dog. This nigga
That's
Drake
cool.
been doing it over 10 years
That's cool.
and been number one if like 90% of the motherfucking time.
Probably like 95. If
billions upon billions of sales. Four, five, yeah. two different major record companies keep the lights on because of Drake.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The whole company would be bankrupt. Yeah. Oh, man, I'm telling you, man.
But if we stick in the music.
You can, yeah, yeah,
that's
yeah.
A, but I'm that's just, it, because that's if we stick in the music. And if we talking about influence.
So get a nigga.
I said he's a phenomenal rapper.
Get a nigga the same chance that, cut the nigga the same bell you cutting these other niggas. Which nigga made movies and did.
Man, well, this, I'm talking about
let
the
Let that nigga
influence.
Stop rapping and
I'm
have
about
time
the
to
influence.
Make it.
I'm
yeah, nigga.
The,
let
I'm
that nigga stop rapping and have time to do shit.
But what I'm
you can't
talking
compare
about,
a nigga,
I'm talking about the influence.
You can't compare what a nigga did in 30-something years to what a nigga doing in 50-something years.
It ain't take
years.
Wayne 30
Fuck
years to do
here,
that
man.
Shit. Wayne came in this motherfucker. Wayne had a span
and,
of fucking,
and
what, 5 years where he really shook the game. How long Drake been in
Wayne
the game?
What has Wayne done since he stopped rapping?
That nigga just dropped a platinum album. Fuck is you talking about?
But I ain't heard no movies.
Just
no,
drop the platinum
I ain't heard
album.
No movies, no business, no basketball leagues. I ain't heard none of that
nigga
shit.
Nigga had a phenomenal podcast, the Young Money radio shit.
See, now
he had Truck Fit.
Now it sound like
he had Truck Fit.
I had
a Truck Fit
now
shirt.
Now it sound like I'm hating, dog, and I'm not hating
I had
Wayne.
A Truck Fit shirt.
Wayne, you one of my
no,
favorite
no,
fucking
nigga.
Artists,
Fuck,
but I got
to
call a
Wayne,
spade.
I had a Truck Fit shirt.
So?
You know what I'm saying? Motherfucker, I got pairs of Vans. I never would have thought about wearing no fucking Vans proud of fucking Wayne. Never.
Did you look down at them hoes in a picture?
Never, bro. You can't compare that. You can't compare these two niggas. You talking about what Wayne? Man, what? Wayne made it. Man, Wayne did what the fuck he did while he was
listen,
while he
listen.
Was rapping. Wayne didn't retire. He doing
what
left
has
while
Wayne
since
done
retired.
Anything of the scale of what Ice Cube has done or what Snoop has done.
He made Drake.
Or what Drake's
he made fucking
but he's
Drake.
Done though. What
he made Drake,
done
nigga.
On those
he
levels.
Made Nicki Minaj, nigga.
Get the fuck out of here.
He kept
man.
Baby alive, nigga. The fuck. What has he done? You gonna say what the fuck has Wayne done?
Since he stopped rapping.
These niggas are his sons.
You ain't listening.
These niggas are his sons.
You ain't listening.
You talk about influence? That's the most influential artist ever in the rap game. Ever. Say I'm wrong.
You wrong.
Wayne's not the most influential rapper in the rap game ever.
You was wrong about 10 minutes ago.
Oh, man, this shit is fucking bananas. You serious? What's in that cup?
Right juice.
That shit's crazy.
The
my
right
nigga
juice,
like,
nigga.
Yeah, I don't know. That's bananas. Ever. Ever.
I can't believe I can't believe I made a podcast with a nigga that think like this.
Ever.
I can't
Most
believe that.
Most influential artist ever.
I'm hiring, dog. We need a new
Lil Wayne.
We need a new host on the Throat in the Game podcast because this nigga gotta go.
Ever. That be real, bro.
Nah, it's not ever. Jay-Z and Tupac.
Hey, this is cute. This is all this shit is cute. All the I'm not gonna agree with you. I get it. It's cute. It's
hey,
cute.
I'm
it's
not
cute.
Comfortable with you calling me
I don't
cute
give a fuck
22
at this
times.
Point. That's cute.
Stop calling me cute, dog.
But to say that this nigga is not the most influential artist ever.
Nah, man, it's Jay-Z and Tupac first.
Before I.
Jay-Z and Tupac.
On top of Wayne?
On top of, no, he's saying on top of Jay-Z.
Oh, man, you too?
Yeah, Pac changed.
He said, you too?
Pac changed the fucking game.
I get it. And that's why I said before I just say, just stick a nail in it. I want to be sure that I'm making sure
they
that
can't
I.
Hear, they can't
I,
hear what
I
he
digested.
Said. So you need to tell him what he said.
He said Pac changed the game.
There you
Pac,
go,
you
got to
put a Pac above Wayne.
I think so too, though. I think that's the general consensus too that Pac and Jay-Z is what more influential.
Boys before
amongst African Americans?
Black people skating the fuck
in. At the volume that they was that they,
no, he just added, he didn't change nothing, he added to it. Pac changed the game.
How did Pac change the game, sir?
Nigga, shit.
I just wanna know. I just wanna know.
Again, they can't hear what he's saying.
Niggas was wearing, niggas wasn't getting, niggas ain't had tattoos, niggas wasn't gangsters, like that. Like that. Man, that nigga Pac came in and then Pac just changed the game. He just changed how all this rap shit went. For real.
Okay.
Living witness.
Okay. Okay. I'm not gonna debate it. I'm not gonna debate it.
But you had Tribe Called Quest, which was big. It, MC
see,
Breed.
they can't hear all that.
MC Breed. They was out. You had
in the meantime, man, make sure y'all follow me on social media, man, at DJ Nightcap, at Breaking Texas, at Texas Fleet DJs, because them two niggas having a whole nother conversation.
So Tupac, then Lil Wayne?
I ain't
going to
say, I'm not putting them in order, but I would definitely.
But a Pac at the top for you, most influential artist ever. You can't say way over Lil Wayne.
Man, that man can say what he wants to.
I'm saying.
Say what he wants to.
That shit crazy to me, dog.
But I'm a living witness.
Rappers wasn't acting like that then, huh?
I think Fat Pat is the most influential artist ever.
Nah.
What time is it? Man.
Tell me I'm wrong. Did he not write the dictionary for our vernacular? And is our vernacular not everywhere across this nation? I've heard E-40 say boppers. I've heard niggas from New York say come and dine. Where they say come and down? What's that little nigga named A-Boogie? A-Boogie like, with the hoodie or some shit like that.
Nigga out of Tokyo.
You know what I'm saying?
Niggas say come and down.
I'm telling you, as a motherfucking professional music person, I've heard our vernacular for decades in music, from other people that ain't from down here. So fuck it. Fat Pat wrote the Southern Dictionary.
Man, I am hyped, South. I don't know, man. I don't know. I'm over you for the day, man.
That boy stunned.
Cause I can't say anything bad about Fat Pat. But I think that's just a curveball just to throw me out. This nigga really kind of want to have me like on my heels today. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to bob and weave his bullshit. You know what I'm saying? It's getting hard. It's getting hard. He stuck me there. It's hard to bob and weave this nigga's bullshit today. This nigga's in his bullshit bag heavily today.
You think so, dog?
Definitely. I'm heavily in your bullshit bag.
I just wanted to see if you was going to argue my Fat Pat, dog.
No, I can't argue that.
But you tripping on this Drake shit.
Nah, I can't argue Fat Pat. I can't argue Fat Pat.
You tripping on this Drake shit though.
I just don't know. I just don't see how and granted, like before we did, bro, like granted Drake might be setting himself up for to be the all time, you know what I'm saying, great, right? Like, you know what I'm saying? Bigger than Jay-Z, more money than Jay-Z, more money than Diddy, more money than Dre, more money than like all these niggas. And money, I know, I'm saying money's not the end all be all measuring stick, but his, like you say, his influence, at least for music, is powerful enough to where when he stops rapping, he should be able to, it should be people coming at him left. I'm sure people coming at him left and right now for business ventures. You know what I'm saying? Well, he should be able to say, boom, and do this and have a, you know what I'm saying, just a great career after rap and influence culture to the degree that somebody like a Jay-Z has, or somebody like a Diddy has, or somebody like a 50 Cent has, or, you know what I'm saying, post-rap career. Because if we're talking about while you're rapping, there's never been an artist that has more influence, in my opinion, than Lil Wayne.
The fact that his only contemporaries is niggas that are really out the fucking game shows you where he is at his point in the game.
But Wayne's influence, while he was still rapping, I still think is bigger than what Drake's influence was influence is now while he's still rapping.
Well, I'm not.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm not arguing that. I'm saying Wayne and Drake in my top five best rappers to ever do it. Best rappers to ever just really change the game. Like, them boys was the game. They were the GOATs, the titans of their decade, or their little run, or you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I get it.
Both of them in the top five. Put them where you want them. But they in there.
I get it, man. You did a shitty job today, man. Well, I am.
Fuck you too, dog. You know what?
I'ma
send you a bunch of pictures on shit so you can start liking more shit and getting more bullshit. Boy, I'm finna set your bitch ass up. Yeah, I'm DJ Nike. Come on.
He said, come on, let's get this bitch over with. Man, this is the Throw in the Game podcast, man.
Yeah. Man, we fuck with y'all, man. Yeah, for real, man.
That nigga say, come on, let's get this. I am DJ Nike.
Thanks for watching. For more all exclusive, all original content all the time, subscribe to Child Time TV.